Genghis Khan, the first great Khan, a man renowned for strategic excellence and ruthless attitude to those who opposed him, leaving behind a trail of destruction never before seen in all of history. Genghis Khan's conquests gave rise to an empire that withstood from 1162 all the way to 1227, establishing dynasties of his ancestors for years to come. Saying that Genghis Khan made an impact on the world around him would be an understatement to say the least. Genghis Khan's impacts and exploits have all been well documented, allowing the historians of today to grasp the true extent of Genghis Khan's conquest. However, one of the most powerful tools for getting a snapshot into the past, for unlocking insights into how the population of today has been influenced by the world around them, is genetic analysis. A tool that allows us to find out not about Genghis Khan's grand strategic ability or how ruthless he was, but rather the genetic impact a single man has had on the world around them. A group of researchers led by Tatiana Zerjal uncovered through DNA surveying of men within Asia that 8% carried a haplotype on their Y chromosome from Genghis Khan. This equates to 0.5% of the world's population, a figure so staggering that Genghis Khan's impact is comparable to the most extreme selective natural events. But how did these researchers reach this conclusion? How do genes allow for insights into the past to be made? To explain this, an understanding of population genetics is required. With the natural populations, a balance exists between neutral processes, including mutation, recombination, and genetic drift, balancing against natural selection. A haplotype can be defined as a set of single nucleotide polymorphisms within the same chromosome that are inherited with one another. For a haplotype to be favored to the extent Zerjal observed, directional natural selection must occur, overcoming the neutral processes present. Directional selection can be seen when an environment favors a specific trait, causing its frequency to increase over time, whilst traits that are not favored will begin to dwindle in frequency. A process that has been observed in the change of the beak shape in Darwin's finches and in moth wing color during the Industrial Revolution. When directional selection occurs, an observable signature is left on the genome. Using these key established principles of population genetics, comparative genomics can allow for the identification of specific genes and traits that have been conserved. These traits give insights into the selective pressures that once existed, with conservative traits being considered advantageous. Zerjal and her team analyzed Y chromosomal lineage as the non-recombining portions of the Y chromosome are essentially haploid, and as such, polymorphisms on this chromosome are extremely valuable for analyzing male gene flow. By typing 2,123 men with 32 microsatellite codominant markers, also known as short tandem repeats, a unique Y haplotype could be constructed for each man sampled. Comparisons of these genetic profiles revealed one haplotype to be present at unusually high rates across 16 different populations that once resided within the Mongol Empire's borders. Using methods established by Nuria Morel and Ian Wilson, analysis of these genetic markers revealed the most common ancestor for these 16 populations was alive 1,000 years ago. The markers also revealed that the single male lineage likely originated in Mongolia, and that it now encompassed 8% of the males in Asia, between China and Uzbekistan. Only one possible conclusion fit this criterion. Genghis Khan must be the common ancestor. Genghis Khan had a lot of children, and I mean a lot. He was known to have hundreds of wives throughout his lifetime, and many hundreds of children, who had established dynasties in his legacy. The social and political environment that Genghis Khan established, with him and his family in positions of power, bestowed a distinct genetic advantage, increasing his genes' frequency. Genghis Khan's military pursuits also resulted in the death of around 40 million, reducing genetic variation in Asia even further. This social prestige is directly reflected in the genetic analysis conducted. This novel form of selection is extremely uncommon in the context of traditional natural selection, due to the requirement of strict social structures. However, as genetic analysis has become more and more accessible, gaining critical insights and discovering elements of the past has become increasingly achievable. Analyzing haplotypes has also allowed for population drift in countries such as Pakistan and Korea to be uncovered. It has been used to demonstrate the effect of social prestige and slavery on the genetic variation of those in colonies. It's also been used in equine science to be able to track the movement of populations to improve breeding and feeding practices. All insights and discoveries that wouldn't be possible without genetic analysis. As genomics develops, so will our understanding of the world, both past and present.